I can't detect the Pacific on their assigned heading. They must have deviated.
We have to assume they're operating off course, or at least without a subspace signal.
Or not operating at all.
I won't have any of that talk. The Pacific, she's out there. Just fell down a well or something. Give me the highest sensor resolution you can. Helm, set course for the next grid, warp 2.
Aye, Captain.
This is Captain Isaac Demir. I hereby accept your commander's offer of emergency assistance, conditionally upon the amicable settlement of terms.
If your commander ensures the safe return of my crew to Federation space, I am certain that it will greatly improve the relations between our peoples and open the door to new diplomatic possibilities in the future.
You endorse the captain's decision to accept aid from the Romulans?
I supported the captain's decision to accept what we had to believe was a genuine offer of humanitarian assistance.
From an enemy vessel.
We are not at war with the Romulans. And the belief that we are put my ship in jeopardy and fostered division among my crew.
What jeopardized the mission was the captain sharing classified information with your crew. A decision that would inspire criminal conspiracy on your ship.
You manufactured an entire mission under suspect pretenses. Respectfully, what did you expect?
You seem to support the notion that Starfleet was involved in a conspiracy.
I suggest that applying the veneer of scientific discovery to a military operation is a dangerous game.
Starfleet disagrees. Furthermore, you failed to address the issue of mutiny.
I refuse to draw legal conclusions.
Fortunately, we don't have to. Testimony from crewman Lawrence proved very enlightening.
Jeff found out that our science consultant is hiding classified sensor logs. The captain's in on it, too.
Not to mention the Admiralty for coming up with this whole mission in the first place.
Look, you don't have to sell me on this Romulan collusion theory.
This all does feel like a treaty-friendly way of smuggling the Pacific to the Romulans. I mean, if we're looking for a motivation.
If someone from Starfleet were going to do it, this would be the way to do it. And if so...
We have to do something.
Well, yeah, I was going to say, if this is actually happening, they're going to kill all the witnesses.
We literally only have hours before that starts to happen.
Well, let's hear it.
Okay. Everything is based on the tractor beams. We combine tractor beams with the Romulans...
No way. Towing won't work.
It's not towing. We can't escape the anomaly, because the warp drive doesn't work with these gravitational frequencies. But... if we could find a reference outside...
Okay, yeah, I get it. We warp along the tractor beam?
And the Romulans get a nice, defenseless Pacific.
Sansweet, this is your department. Is there a way we could disable the Romulans with the tractor beam somehow?
Well, we establish the inner link, but at the right moment, you switch to the exact anti-phase. The equipment couldn't handle it. They'd have to rebuild the whole thing from scratch.
Perfect.
It would do the same to us, too. And for us, that's an integrated system. It could do a lot of damage. All of Section A is tied in there.
I don't think that anyone would complain about making that sacrifice for humanity.
So we're plotting a mutiny?
We're gonna take action. What did you expect?
I don't know. Something a little more legal, maybe?
Starfleet Regulation 3 gives provisions for any means necessary.
That's an order for the captain to decide.
A captain who's treasonous?
We don't know that.
All right, we don't know that. But if we don't take this risk, everyone on board could be killed. We could have another war with Romulus. We can stop that. We need your support on this, Jeff. Are you with us?
Yeah, of course.
We're in position, sir.
Rig the ship for tractor beam.
Tractor interlink established.
Captain Demir.
Now is really not the time.
I understand, sir. It's urgent.
Really gotta stop doing this. Go ahead. Captain, there's going to be an attempt to sabotage the rescue operation.
What are you talking about?
They're in tractor control right now. They're going to use it to destroy the Romulans.
Mr. Lawrence, you're confined to your quarters until further notice.
Aye, sir.
Commander!
Yes, sir.
You have the bridge. Hold position and wait for my orders.
Sir, we could just put security on it.
I'll handle this myself. You have the bridge.
Yes, sir. Hold position relative to the Romulans. Give them a standby signal.
The captain thought confronting the mutineers himself was the best course of action.
He likely was trying to avoid reinforcing the suspicion.
You do realize we're discussing a major breach of protocol here. Pacific had personnel aboard who are specially trained to deal with these sorts of situations. And the captain neglected to use them.
Tractor beam is activated!
Shut it down!
We don't have control!
Bridge to tractor control. Vendray to Captain Demir.
Your actions and the actions of your captain have resulted in the failure of both the scientific and the military aspects of your mission. If it were up to me, I'd have you charged with negligence.
Starfleet doesn't agree.
At this point, 49 crewmen were lost in total, and I won't even tell you the monetary loss the Starfleet suffered, not to mention a completely wasted opportunity to study a cutting-edge Romulan ship up close.
Given the situation, the survival of my crew was far more important than any losses Starfleet may have incurred.
After the explosion, we struggled for 12 days to restore the Pacific to basic functioning order. Even so, we were rapidly losing life support and had very few options left. Engineering reports that we have a maximum of 18 hours before total reactor failure.
Shuttles?
Are you suggesting a shuttle evacuation?
We could evacuate a total of 70 with the craft that we have on board.
That's over 100 shy, Mr. Owsley.
It would stretch our life support by an extra shift or so. And for those in the shuttles, a fully loaded shuttle would have about 3 days for rescue.
Nobody stands a good chance in this anomaly. Much less separated. And how would they get rescued anyway? Lieutenant Rader, any luck with the gravity harmonics?
It's no good, ma'am. It would take weeks to figure this place out.
Even if we could, we're not going anywhere with one to sell.
The Class C shuttles do have transporters, ma'am. I think they could be used for rescue, even from a safe range.
I couldn't ask anybody to leave the rest of the crew behind just to save themselves.
You wouldn't have to ask. Not me, anyway. I'll stay behind.
Me too.
I'll be here.
Thank you, everybody. But I can't ask for volunteers. This should be my decision. Continue with repairs. I want to get everything we possibly can out of that reactor.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll be in my ready room.
Enter. This is my first act as captain.
choosing who lives and who dies. How is that acceptable? How can I make that choice?
Even if you could only save one of us, wouldn't you?
Who would I choose? How would I choose?
That sounded like a very emotionally taxing decision, Commander. But perhaps, if you follow protocol.
I would have preferred to not be stranded with 49 dead crewmen outside the Federation space with no reasonable expectation of rescue. Starfleet put us at risk. Your clever little secret mission put us at risk. Most of us didn't know the risks. How could we have been prepared? How dare you judge me and my crew from the office that authorized this reckless mission?
Perhaps it's best if we conclude here. I hope you can understand my frustration. I thought we could salvage some good from this whole incident. But some missions really are lost causes. Thank you for your time, Commander. You'll be pleased to hear that Starfleet Command does share some of your sentiments. This mission may be the start of an operational overhaul.
Commander Vondre? Pardon me, ma'am.
Lieutenant Whitney, was it?
Yes, ma'am. It's an honor to finally get to meet you face to face.
The honor is mine. I understand you were steering the Velocity that day.
Yes, ma'am, but I think we just got lucky.
Take some credit. Be proud of the role you played. You deserve it.
Helm, we're done here. Set course for the next grid.
Wait. I got something. A huge energy spike, sir.
Helm, cancel the warp. Turn the ship around.
Canceling warp, sir.
Open the shipwide broadcast. Crew of the Pacific, colleagues, and friends, this is your acting captain. Right now we find ourselves in a difficult situation, but there's one last thing we must do. The shuttles offer a possibility of survival, but as you know, they cannot carry us all. I intend to...
This is Captain Quavers of the Starship Velocity. Anybody need a hand?
Thank you. Melissa. I'm at the USPA facility in Virginia, and you won't believe what we've... Well, I don't want to spoil it, but meet me at the Rockhold tomorrow at 1800.
So you've been well?
I can't stop thinking about it.
I know. But you know, we made some really incredible discoveries out there. The things that we would have never thought.
People died. Lucy. People died out there. And I was about to make myself responsible for dozens more. Because we had to go out and play Explorer.
It's more than just pretend, Elisa. We found a completely new civilization out there.
Ruins and rocks. And now it's not even that.
Remember those inscriptions that we found?
Yes?
I don't know who they are, but from one of my scans... Just look.
What? This can't be. This is a translation.
Read it.
This is poetry. When this arm, once our home, dies, we will be far. We sleep on the arm of a green forever. Stillness shrouds our lively place, far from the noise and dust of this star home. Why haven't I heard about this? This is incredible. This is beautiful.
And that's just a fragment of what we have. They think there might be a way to find out where these people have gone. That what we found was just a guidepost. This isn't the end.